Okay, so hello, welcome to our weathers channel, and today we will be talking about many different weather factors. So first off, let's start with fronts. So we right now have a warm front coming up from Texas, and there's a small one going east right around here. We have cold fronts on the west side of the country, and there's also a cold front right by us in Massachusetts, which is definitely why we got some coats coming out today. So we also mainly have a stationary front running through the majority of the country right now, and that will definitely stay there for quite a bit. So that stationary front is going to linger, causing definitely some rain over in that area. So if you're right around the stationary front, I'd be careful and bring your umbrella with you. Okay, so now let's head over to Scofi with some more weather factors.
Now let's take a look at temperature. As you can see, it's a bit colder up north due to the result from the continental polar air mass located up in Canada. If we look down towards the south, you can see a significant rise in the temperature, as the temp in the north getting down to 27 degrees, and as south, it gets up to 75 degrees. As you can see, the dew point in the south is higher, making it more humid, and it corresponds to the warmer weather down south. Up in the north, over by North Dakota and Minnesota, dew point is closer to the temperature, and it means that we will probably get some rain over in this area. If we look down at Texas, the dew point reaches 68 degrees, one of the highest in today, meaning more humid day in Texas. Okay, now let's take a look at the dew point and temperature. As you can see, the dew point starts pretty far apart, but around here, it gets pretty close, indicating that it probably rained and or a light sprinkle. And then as they grow farther apart, it indicates that the rain has stopped and it's gonna be clear weather. You can see all these jagged lines down, and that's the wind chill related to the winds. See, in the middle, we have some low pressure systems in place, and with the cold front moving through, we will most likely result with rain in that area. Over closer to the east, we have two high pressure systems in place located over Alabama and Kentucky. So that will result in nice. As you can see, over in California, we have a few low pressure systems in place, which will most likely result in moist, cool weather, and it can end up resulting in rain over California. Liliana.
So we can see that all of the storms are actually moving east, a little towards us over here. And there are actually some more heavy rains coming up from the south to the north, moving northeast. So with all these weather patterns, we can notice they're mainly moving northeast, but it does look like they will not hit us and they will just pass over us. We might get some light rain, but not too much. So also we notice that the isobars, which indicate how strong the wind is, are a lot more frequent wherever there's a lot of snow or rain. So when you see a lot of those isobars, especially in snowy and rainy areas, that means there will be stronger winds. So be careful for that wind chill. Thanks for watching us on our weather channel, and stay dry out there. There we go.